Academic Writing, Lecture 3, Unity and Coherence. Learning objectives. Identify unity and coherence. Study using repetition of key nouns and key noun substitutes. Compare consistent pronouns. Employ transition signals. Distinguish logical order. What is unity in a paragraph? Unity in a paragraph means that the entire paragraph should focus on one single idea. The supporting details should explain the main idea. The concluding sentence should end the paragraph with the same idea. Thus, a unified paragraph presents a thought, supports it with adequate details, and completes it with a conclusion. Unity is a very important characteristic of good paragraph writing. Paragraph unity means that one paragraph is about only one main topic. That is, all the sentences, the topic, supporting sentences, the detail sentences, and sometimes the concluding sentence are all telling the reader about one main topic. If your paragraph contains a sentence or some sentences that are not related to the main topic, then we say that the paragraph lacks unity, or that the sentence is off topic. So, if your paragraph is about the advantages of owning a compact car, discuss only that. Do not discuss the disadvantages. Furthermore, discuss only one advantage, such as gas economy, in each paragraph. If you begin to discuss another advantage, start a new paragraph. Sometimes it is possible to discuss more than one aspect of the same idea in one paragraph if they are closely related to each other. For example, you could discuss gas economy and low maintenance costs in the same paragraph because they are closely related, but you should not discuss both. Gas economy and easier parking in the same paragraph because they are not closely related. The second part of unity is that every supporting sentence must directly explain or prove the main idea. For example, in a paragraph about the high cost of prescription drugs in the United States, you could mention buying drugs from pharmacies outside the United States as an alternative, but if you write several sentences about buying drugs outside the United States, you are getting off the topic, and your paragraph will not have unity. So, what is coherence in a paragraph? Coherence means establishing a relationship between the ideas presented in a paragraph. It brings about a rationale in the arrangement of the ideas, which are introduced either in the chronological order or in the order of importance. Besides, transitions that compare, contrast, illustrate, add, or show cause and effect build logical bridges. The ideas that expressed in the paragraph flow smoothly from one to the other in a logical sequence. This helps the reader to understand the paragraph. So, what is coherence? Coherence. An essay must have coherence. The sentences must flow smoothly and logically from one to the next as they support the purpose of each paragraph, improving the thesis. Just as the last sentence in a paragraph must connect back to the topic sentence of the paragraph, The last paragraph of the essay should connect back to the thesis by reviewing the proof and restating the thesis. Example of essay with problems of unity and coherence. Here is an example of a brief essay that includes a paragraph that does not support the thesis. Many people are changing their diets to be healthier. People are concerned about pesticides, steroids, and antibiotics in the food they eat. Many now shop for organic foods since they don't have the pesticides used in conventionally grown food. Meat from chicken and cows that are not given steroids or antibiotics are gaining in popularity, even though they are much more expensive. More and more people are eliminating pesticides, steroids, and antibiotics from their diets. Eating healthier also is beneficial to the environment, since there are less pesticides poisoning the earth. Pesticides getting into the waterways is creating a problem with drinking water. Historically, safe drinking water has been a problem. It is believed the ancient Egyptians drank beer since the water was not safe so to drink. Brewing beer killed the harmful organisms and bacteria in the water from the Nile. There is a growing concern about eating genetically modified foods, and people are opting for non-genetically modified diets. Some people say there are more allergic reactions and other health problems resulting from these foods. Others are concerned because there are no long-term studies which clearly show no adverse health effects such as cancers or other illnesses. Avoiding GMO food is another way people are eating healthier food. So, how just one paragraph can take away from the effectiveness of the essay in showing how people are changing to healthier food since the unity and coherence are affected? There is no longer unity among all the paragraphs. The thought pattern is disjointed and the essay loses its coherence. Transitions and logical flow of ideas. Transitions are words, groups of words or sentences that connect one sentence to another or one paragraph to another. They promote a logical flow from one idea to the next and overall unity and coherence. While transitions are not needed in every sentence or at the end of every paragraph, they are missed when they are omitted since the flow of thoughts becomes disjointed or even confusing. There are different types of transitions. Time, for example, before, after, during, in the meantime, nowadays, space, over, around, under. Examples, for instance, one example is comparison, on the other hand, the opposing view, consequence, as a result, subsequently. There are just a few examples. The idea is to paint a clear logical connection between sentences and between paragraphs. Coherence refers to a certain characteristic or aspect of writing. Literally, the word means to stick together. Coherence in writing means that all the ideas in a paragraph flow smoothly from one sentence to the next sentence. With coherence, the reader has an easy time understanding the ideas that you wish to express. Consider the paragraph, for example. So, listen to the text. My hometown is famous for several amazing natural features. First, it is noted for the Witten River, which is very wide and beautiful. On either side of this river, which is 175 feet wide, are many willow trees, which have long branches that can move gracefully in the wind. In autumn, the leaves of these trees fall and cover the river banks like golden snow. Second, on the other side of this town is Witten Hill, which is unusual because it is very steep. Even though it is steep, climbing this hill is not dangerous because there are some firm rocks along the sides that can be used as stairs. There are no trees around this hill, so it stands clearly against the sky and can be seen from many miles away. The third amazing feature is the big old tree. This tree stands 200 feet tall and is probably about 600 years old. These three landmarks are truly amazing and make my hometown a famous place. So, major connectors. Look at the words. So, do you see how they help guide the reader? For example, consider the words first, second, and the third amazing feature. We can call these words major connectors. Major connectors help organize the main parts of your paragraph. This paragraph has three main parts. First, a part about the Witten River. Second, a part about Witten Hill. And third, a part about the big old tree. Another way of saying this is that this paragraph has three main points which are indicated by the major connectors. Using such major connectors is an important way of providing coherence in a paragraph. So let's talk about minor connectors. What about the other words in bold, such as those appearing in the phrases these trees and this hill? We can call these minor connectors. Minor connectors provide coherence to a paragraph by connecting sentences within each of the main parts of your paragraph. That is, when you write about your main points, you can use minor connectors to link your details to each main point. As for the minor connectors, we can divide them into three groups. The first group of minor connectors provides coherence for the first main point, the Mercury program. There is only one minor connector in this first group. In addition, although it is possible to have more than one depending on how many details you have to support your first main point. The second group of minor connectors consists of that is also and also the phrase for example in the sentence, for example, some astronauts. Notice that this last minor connector is the same as the major connector at the beginning of the paragraph. However, the function of each is different depending on the meaning of the sentence. The third group of minor connectors in this particular paragraph also has one member, which is other girls included. So, we can speak about such common connectors, also called transitions, as for example, for instance, as another example, on the one hand, one example of, finally, on the other hand, so in conclusion, however, but also first, second, third, etc. So, in English grammar, a signal phrase is a phrase, clause, or sentence that introduces a quotation, paraphrase, or summary. It is also called a dialogue guide. A signal phrase includes a verb, such as said or wrote, along with the name of the person who is being quoted. Although a signal phrase most often appears before a quotation, the phrase may instead come after it or in the middle of it. Editors and style guides generally advise writers to vary the positions of signal phrases to improve readability throughout a text. So, for example, how to vary signal phrases. Maya Angelou said, "Start loving yourself before you ask someone else to love you." Start loving yourself before you ask someone else to love you, Maya Angelou said. Start loving yourself, Maya Angelou said, before you ask someone else to love you. As Mark Twain observed, keep away from people who try to belittle your ambitions. So, etc. These were the examples. So, common signal phrase verbs include the following. For example, look at these verbs. Argue, claim, confirm, point out, illustrate, imply, insist, think, etc. So let's speak about context, flow, and citation. In nonfiction, signal phrases are used to give attribution rather than set of dialogue. They are important to use when you are paraphrasing or quoting someone's ideas other than your own, as at best it's intellectually dishonest if not plagiarism to do so, depending on the amount of text used and how closely it mirrors the original text. A signal phrase usually names the author of the source and often provides some context for the source material. A signal phrase indicates the boundary between your words and the source's words. So, at the end of the lecture, I would like to speak about punctioning signal phrases. So, punctioning signal phrases in a sentence is simple and straightforward. If the quotation begins the sentence, the words telling who is speaking are set off with a comma unless the quotation ends with a question mark or an exclamation point. As a part of speech, transition words are used to link words, phrases, or sentences. They help the reader to progress from one idea expressed by the author to the next idea. Thus, they help to build up coherent relationships within the text. So, summary and unity means that the paragraph discusses one main idea. Coherence means establishing a relationship between the ideas presented in a paragraph. Coherence refers to a certain characteristic or aspect of writing. Transitions are words, groups of words, or sentences that connect one sentence to another or one paragraph to another. A signal phrase is also called a quotative frame or a dialogue guide. And questions. So will you answer these questions? Do all of the sentences support the topic sentence? The second question. Is there a logical order to the support? Are combining devices used to tie points or sentences together? And sources which you can use in order to prepare to your practical lessons. Till the lesson is over. Goodbye.